Anything surprise you in the OECD numbers? Is it does it conform with what you and, for that matter, the Fed is expecting?
Well, I think it's things that were already anticipated. We've seen a lot of evidence that China was encountering a slow patch and European growth had slowed quite significantly. So I don't think the revisions are, you know, particularly large. I don't think it really changes the outlook in a meaningful way.
Now you have a piece out in a Bloomberg Opinion just this morning, actually, and you say that it could turn around, that we shouldn't get too complacent. And you say, in part, the case for waiting has lessened somewhat, waiting that is for to raise rates. Financial conditions have eased in 2019 as the U.S. stock market has rebounded from its December slump. Now that China is focused on stimulating growth, the global growth outlook is improving. And if U.S.-China talks make progress, some of the uncertainties on the trade front could be resolved. So is, in fact, there an upside on the growth, and therefore is it possible we could see some rate increases after all?
Well, I think that the factors that I cited in the article are very, you know, recent. So the first quarter for financial conditions much easier than in the fourth quarter. The fact that the trade talks with China look like they're going to have a good outcome rather than a bad outcome. And the fact that China is really stimulating their economy all point to the fact that maybe the weakest, the greatest risk on global growth has already passed, and so that the OECD forecasts are just catching up with what's already happened.
But they're not the only one. And I point to Eric Rosengren, the Boston Fed president, yesterday. He was speaking, and he talked about the equities pricing in more risk, and they were going to have to wait for a few more months in order to see if the risks overall were actually going to be transmitted to the U.S. economy. What do you make of the fact that a Fed president said equity markets are pricing in too much risk?
Well, I think that he's saying that there's probably more uncertainty in the economic outlook than the stock market is probably currently registering. Look, I don't think the Fed's going to change on a dime. I think the first quarter, for example, is going to be very weak. You had a government shutdown. You had uncertainty on trade. You had a delay in the tax refunds. So I think the first quarter is going to print a very weak GDP, and then I think that's going to maybe even raise the risk in the market's perception of the risk to the economy. But I think once we get past the first quarter, second quarter is going to be firmer. By the time we get into the second half of the year, I think this idea that the Fed is done is going to be over.
So it's not just, though, when it comes to sort of equities and what the economic risk is. Morgan Stanley also had their 10-year call. They lowered it to 2.35% for the end of this year. If you're looking at markets and what it's telling you about the economy, what does a 2.35 mean on the 10-year for the economy and for long-term growth?
Well, if the economy would have to be very weak to get, I think, a 10-year yield of 2.35. That would basically imply that the Fed was not only done, but the next move from the Fed would be a cut in interest rates. I don't see that as the most likely scenario. I think what's going to be interesting is the March FOMC meeting, what the Fed shows in terms of their summary of economic projections. And my guess is that the median path for short-term interest rates is still going to show a little bit of an upward slope to it in the latter part of 2019 and in 2020.
So if in fact, Bill, that we have seen a trough or we're near a trough in the growth projections, what's going to bring it back up? Is that a matter of global growth overall? Is it a matter of resolution of the China dispute? What would bring it back up?
Well, I think the most important thing is China's gone from trying to restrain the non-banking financial sector to trying to actually stimulate the economy again through fiscal policy and credit easing. We've seen this from China many times before, that they try to tighten up, the economy slows, it scares them, and then they re-push their foot on the accelerator. So I think we're in that process again. So I would guess that the China outlook will improve, and as that happens, the demand for foreign goods and services into China will increase. We'll start to see Europe do a little bit better. And the U.S. is going to get benefit from the fact that a lot of uncertainties that existed on trade could very easily be resolved over the next few months.